Hello and welcome to a demo of the Batfish Enterprise Sandbox. In this demo, I will show you how you can make sure that the changes you are about to make to your network are safe and will not cause a security violation or an outage. I will show this demo on this network. What I have fed into Batfish is simply the configuration files for all the devices that you see on the screen here. Based on that configuration information alone, Batfish is able to figure out how these devices connect to each other, how the routing works, and what the security posture of the network looks like. With respect to security, what we have here is that we have a firewall at the edge of the data center, and the rules of the firewall are data center wide, so they are meant to protect all the hosts in the network. And as an additional layer of security, we have ACLs on the store routers here, or top of rack routers, with rules that are specific to the hosts or services that are deployed on that rack. The change I will focus on is giving access to a new application that has been deployed on the server here. I am showing this server here for illustration purposes, but typically in an analysis, the server information is not needed at all. So per my security design, to make this change, that is to give access to a new application on this server, what I need to do is to open up access to the server at the firewall and at these two tors here. So I have spec'd this change out already. So what I need to do is to allow access to that server to these ports on the top of rack switches, which is ASW001A and ASW001B. And on the firewall, I need to define a new address book that corresponds to that destination server, define a new application. I only need to define a new application for SMTP 2525. Because Juno's SMTP already has port 25, so that application is an inbuilt onto Juniper SRXs. And then I need to update my security policy for zone-to-zone traffic, such that it allows the new address and the new port. So what I want to make sure that if I were to apply these changes to my network, the new mail server will get access, and there will be no collateral damage in the sense that connectivity to anything else will not be impacted. So let's see how I can do that. So to test out a change, we go here. We open up the configuration file of the box I want to change, so ASW001A. Click here. It'll give me the option to edit the configuration. So what I need to do is take this new policy term, allow SMTP, and add it to the end here. My demo change. Save the change here. So now I want to open up the other file. So I made a change to A router. Now I need to make a change to the B router. There. So the change is essentially the same. Okay, I will save this as well. Then I will open up the firewall. Change for the firewall. What do I need to do? I need to add this address book entry. So see where my address books are defined. So this is where my address books are defined. So I added this one here. And second, what I need to do is to define a new application. So let's see where my applications are. Here are my applications. So I add a new application here. So that's good. Then I need to open up destination address. And we already have a term for mail transfer. So what I will do is add the destination address here. And I will then add my new application here. So that's good. Save changes and say, you know, open up mail. So now what Batfish is doing is basically doing a comprehensive analysis of the change you just proposed and is providing you a view of the differences between the new snapshot you created with the change and the baseline snapshot you have. I will focus on the compare tab here, but Batfish gives you the opportunity to analyze your proposed changes by interactively testing how traffic on it will behave. For instance, you can run a virtual traceroute, or if you have set up network-wide policies, you can see whether all your policies are passing with respect to change or not. But in this demo, I will focus on the compare tab, which focuses on how the new change snapshot differs from any baseline snapshot that you want to compare against. And it categorizes those changes in various categories. So here, for instance, it's showing what changes I made. So, you know, this is, you saw that happen, like these are the changes I made, so you can see them here. One of the most useful views here is the reachability matrix. What the reachability matrix shows you is that from all possible sources in the network to all possible destinations, if there's any flow that will be removed or added as a result of the change. And there's blue color for added. So what we are seeing here is that from all the sources in the network to these destinations, there has been some additional connectivity or new flows will be carried. So now ASW001 and 001A, I opened up access to 25 and 2525. So also these two columns are actually expected. But whoa, what we are seeing here is that I have accidentally opened up access to these ISW routers as well, which I did not intend to do. So clearly I have done something wrong here and I'm causing collateral damage. So while I'm allowing the traffic I wanted to allow, I'm also accidentally allowing the traffic I didn't mean to allow at all. So this, since I did not change the configuration of ISWs, this must be a result of the firewall changes I made. So let me go see what I did wrong. So I added address book here, that seems okay. I added a new application, that seems okay. Oh, I see. So I was trying to be lazy here and added my destination address and port to an existing term, but this term was actually allowing other addresses as well and other applications as well. So this is where this accidental opening up has happened. So what I really should be doing is to create like a new term and see if that does the right thing. So to do that, what I can do is go to the sandbox again. Edit configuration. So this is the buggy term I added. So I really should be creating a new term here. Let me just copy it here and permit SMTP new permit. Let me just copy paste that. Actually, I need to delete these lines here and give access to only SMTP new. So I will do that. Cut and paste here. ICMP was not part of my spec, so I will take that out as well. I will do this then. And I will do this. And finally, I will do this. And I want to make sure that I delete the two lines I added earlier here. So now I think I've created a completely fresh term that's giving access to only the address group I wanted to give access to and the ports I wanted to give access to. So I can save this change and give it a new name. Correctly open up mail, of course. And now Batfish is doing the same thing. It's comparing my second proposal to my original proposal. And it's showing you the differences in the configurations between the two. So I deleted those two terms that I had overloaded onto the earlier term. And I create a fresh term, of course. Let's see how my end-to-end reachability is impacted. This is computing, and it looks like, you know, the right thing somewhat has happened. ISW, which I had given access to, now it shows up as removed. And now what I'm really interested in is that, is my second proposal completely correct or not with respect to the baseline? So it's comparing essentially my second proposal to my first baseline. So this is a clean shot that's telling you that all you've done end-to-end is opened up mail access to ASW001A and 001B, and now other connectivity in the network has been impacted. So this is the view for this particular change, giving you the confidence that the change is correct in opening up the access, and it has no collateral damage with respect to allowing or blocking any of the flows. I hope you enjoyed this demo and you find these capabilities useful. You can always send us your thoughts via Slack or via GitHub. And thank you. Bye for now.